Race Director Chris Tilley in communication with the drivers via the Raceiver one-way communication device. And Jason Manley out of Loudoun, Tennessee, and Alan Champ out of Morristown, Tennessee, set to bring him to green. Eyes on him. Green's out, and here we go. Again, the top four will transfer. Alan Champ going to jump to the race lead. Jason Manley going to be second. Steve Smith up between cars. He's up to the third position. And look out. We've got a spin. Carnage down in turn number four. The 9A of Philip Anderson got sideways, and they started stacking them in behind him. Mike Smith and the four involved. The one of Kevin Gill also sitting there. The K-37 of Drew Kennedy. And the 18 of Dustin Kanzler all involved. Way getting the left front corner of the nose piece pulled away on Philip Anderson's number 9A. Udawal, Tennessee's Kevin Gill also sitting there stopped. And it looks like we are going to have one car go on the hook here down in turn number four. Flag racing laps of scheduled distance, and again, only the top four transfer on to the main event.
Can you imagine the feeling sitting back there in about row four or five, knowing you drove a long ways, you drove your heart out to get where you're at, and if you don't get in top four, you may have to go on the trailer and go home. These guys are going to race like this is the last race they ever been in.
That's about right. And, you know, Doug, you said it earlier, probably the best field of steelhead late models that may have ever been at one particular racetrack right here at Volunteer Speedway tonight.
And we're going green flag racing, 12 laps.
And a green flag waved, and I don't know if that start's going to go or not. Caution's out. Caution is out.
And you can see the cars bunching up on the backstretch. If those cars are not even when they come to that cone, that starter doesn't like it. So we will.
There are a pair of orange cones, orange pylons, sitting up on top of the inside retaining wall. And they want the cars to stay two-by-two double file until the front row gets in between there. And then Chief Starter Robbie Perkins will drop the Robbie Williams will drop the green flag.
Well, I see you, Robbie Perkins, too. They're on 460 modified.
Exactly. Green's out, and we'll try it again here. And looks like we will go green. Nope, we got a spin coming off turn number two. No, and no, we're staying green. I thought the caution was out. Nobody did stop on the racing surface, so we'll stay green. Alan Champ out in front in the 14 machine. Jason Welsh is slowing on the front straightaway. Now we got caution. Caution is out. Holy cow.
The 29 and the 32, the 29 had slowed.
Believe he had a flat tire possibly, and he slowed, and the 32 of Jason Manley, heavy contact.
No place to go. But watch the car drive away.
Well,
goes to show you how safe these race cars are.
It looks like he does have a flat left front tire, maybe.
Yeah, he probably got that when they all bunched up over on that backstretch a while ago. But nobody stopped. The racetrack was not blocked. Therefore, no caution brought out at the time. Robbie Williams up there in that bullpen. That's what I call it tonight at the gap, the bullpen. Because he's definitely got his hands full with them flags tonight.
Yes, sir.
Man's single double, single file restart. Alan Champ out front. Steve Smith second.
And Green's back at it. Here we go again. Only the top four will transfer on to the main event. Steve Smith trying to pull the slide job. He slides up in front of Alan Champ off turn two. They make some contact. But the Rayburn chassis machine of Steve Smith's got to go to the point. Alan Champ looking beneath him off 2-4 or off 4-4, the runner-up slot. Kevin Gillis made his way into third, has the Cleveland Speedway regular. Man on the bubble right now in the 07 machine is Jason Cardwell. He rides in the fourth spot. First man on the outside looking in is Steve Carr in fifth, and we got caution. Caution is out as the 18 car of Gary Crittenden sets spun to the bottom of turn at number three. That'll draw the caution flag.
This restart is going to be very interesting with Steve Smith. He's pulled away from Alan Chank, but did the slide job and settled this thing like 2 men because really going to get competitive. Everybody's racing to get in that top four spot. Can Steve Smith hold off Alan Chamfer when Alan tried the slide job that Steve used to get to the point a while ago?
This A-Main this evening is going to be something to behold, Doug. There's no doubt about that as we get set to come back to green. Steve Smith in charge of the restart. Eyes on him. Green's out, and here we go. Gill looking to the bottom of Champ, but not able to make the move off turn number two with Smith. Now pulling away a bit from Champ as Gill looks beneath Champ again, off four down the main straightaway. Smith the leader, Champ second, Gill is third. Cardwell rides in fourth with Carr in fifth. Again, only the top four will make their way in to tonight's 40-lap $5,000 to win main event. We're halfway to the house, and this one's six down, six to go. Gill almost had the pass made on Champ there off turn two. Not able to make the move, though, as we've got five to go with the line this time, Doug.
Look here, going into one. I think you're going to see a drop down again. He's gaining momentum, trying to find that moisture down low to stay up out of the black stuff. And Champ up high keeps his momentum going.
Champ and Gill continue to battle for the second spot, and all this is letting Steve Smith scoot away from that battle for second. As we're two-thirds of the way home, eight down, four to go. We'll have nine in the books right here. Powell, Tennessee, Steve Smith in a C.J. Rayburn race car continues to show the way out in front here in last chance showdown number one. As we're about to get the two-lap to go signal right here, there'll be two to go. This time by 10 in the books, two remain. Smith working at Rayburn off turn number four, had problems in time trials, only got one lap started in the fifth spot, but looking to finish first right here as the white flag goes out. One lap to settle the issue here in tonight's first last chance showdown. Smith down the back straightaway for the final time into turn three off turn four. Powell, Tennessee, Steve Smith, the winner of first last the last chance showdown number one. Alan Champ will come home in second.
Former World 100 winner, too, I think.
Runner-up.
Runner-up, okay.
Runner-up up at Elmore, one of the big shows. Steve Smith, the winner here tonight in the first last chance showdown. Alan Champ comes home second. Kevin Gill going to be third, and fourth going to be the 07 of Jason Cardwell. So those four in the show. Cardwell fourth. Hello to all you all in Tier Parking over on the back straightaway. Hope you're enjoying your evening here at Volunteer Speedway.
So if you've not been out of your seat for a minute, you might want to scoot forward a little bit and get ready for this start. 12 laps, four cars transfer.
And some of the drivers not making the call for this one. The 70 of Brent Hensley, the 31 of Greg Estes, the 47 of Brad Hall, the 11 of Kip Sawyer, and the 77 of Perry Delaney. 17 scheduled to go. It'll be an even dozen, and only a third of them are going to make their way in. Everyone else will be on the trailer done for the night. Dean Bowen and Brad Lowe to bring them to green. Green's out, and here we go. Good-looking start there. Yes, it was. They're side-by-side. Dean Bowen out in front, but we got caution on the bottom side of turn number one, the 32 machine. That's L.J. George's Shannon Bearden looping that car, and that will draw the caution here early in this one.
Watch them up and watch that outside line. It's got to be pretty even at that cone. There'll be no brake checking. Nobody going to go nowhere till they're side by side.
You know, I miss the days when they raced with the radios where you could bring the scanners and listen to the drivers talk. This would be interesting tonight, no doubt about that, as the green is out, and we will try it again. Dean Bowen in the 55, the 16 of Brad Lowe, and Lowe nosing out in front in the 16. Bowen rides in second as the 9 machine of Heath Heineman and the 12T of Dan Tipton go side by side for third and fourth. The 2 of Danny Yoder rides in the 5th spot at this point. And the field's starting to get strung out. Looks like we may stay clean and green here for a few laps as we've got two down. And keep an eye on the one machine of Barrett Lowe out of Asheville, North Carolina. Started toward the back of the field looking to get his way into the top five. Battling with Danny Yoder, and Lowe is in the fifth. Off turn number four down the front straightaway. Meanwhile, Brad Lowe shows the way out in front into 16. Dean Bowen is second in the double nickel. Dan Tipton starting to close in on him now in that red number 12. And a final transfer spot. Barrett Lowe grabs that transfer spot. He started in the ninth position and is working the basement. The bottom side has made his way up to the fourth position. Meanwhile, up front, Brad Lowe out for a Friday night ride here, pulling away from the field as we start to close in on the midpoint. Dan Tipton now trying to pressure Dean Bowen for the runner-up spot off two. Not able to make the move, and the man that's been fast so far, Barrett Lowe in the number one, starting to reel those two in as Tipton and Bowen battle side by side through turns one and two. As we are halfway to the house, and we'll be one lap past the midpoint right here when the 16 of Brad Lowe crosses the start-finish line, seven down, five to go. Tipton and Bowen, best battle for position up front. They continue to duel side by side. Tipton will slide up in front of Bowen. Bowen gets a handful of wheel, tries to work back beneath him, but nothing doing. And now Lowe closes up on Bowen off of turn four, trying to grab the third spot away from the North Carolina driver. A pair of North Carolina natives now battling for third and fourth. Meanwhile, the 16 machine of Brad Lowe continues to show the way out in front as the 14 car of Justin Fairbanks sees the layover flag for race leader Brad Lowe. Tipton is second. Barrett Lowe is third. The 55 of Dean Bowen in the final transfer spot with the 9 of Heath Heineman now starting to close in on Bowen a bit for that fourth and final transfer spot as we're about to see the white flag off of turn number four. One lap to go in last chance showdown number two, and it is all Brad Lowe out in front right now. They're chasing the Knoxville, Tennessee driver down the back straightaway. Get off of turn four. Knoxville, Tennessee's Brad Lowe will be the winner of last chance showdown at number two. Second, going to be the 12T of Dan Tipton. Third, going to go to the one of Barrett Lowe. And fourth looks to be the 55 of North Carolina's Dean Bowen. So those five in the show after we get them across the scales. Fourth, the 55 of Whiteville, North Carolina's Dean Bowen. Third in the one machine from Asheville, North Carolina, Barrett Lowe. Second, the 12T out of Kingston, Tennessee, Dan Tipton. And we'll make it official once he crosses the scales here. Winner of last chance showdown number two in the 16 out of Knoxville, Tennessee. Big round of applause for Brad Lowe.
Unreal.
Now flags up, race fans. The one to go signals out, and we are coming to green next time by. The veteran and the youngster on the front row. The 90 of the veteran, Mark Martin, into his outside. In the 15, the youngster, Ethan Hunter. Vic Hills, Steelhead, Late Model Championship. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's showtime. Mark Martin jumps to the race lead. Ethan Hunter's going to be in second. Ross White third. Corey Hitchcock is fourth with the 17 of Matt Henderson fifth. And looks like we are going to get lap one in the book cleanly and safely. They are all over the place trying to find some running room. Martin up next to the wall, almost lost it. Hunter closes in on him now as they race off into turn number one. You see the sparks from the brakes coming out from beneath the rears of the race cars. Martin the leader, Hunter is second, White third, Hitchcock fourth. Henderson is in fifth, Josh Collins sixth. McCarter rides in the seventh spot in the 51 machine. Sice is eighth. Travel 9 and the 30 of Ryan King around Josh Henry to be the final car into the top 10 as we've got four in the books. 36 remain. And Now Mark Martin looking high, wide, and handsome at this point out in front. Martin short away, Hunter second, as Corey Hedgecock starting to put some heat on White Lightning. Ross White for the third spot, but White will hang on to it for the time being. You got a lot of feature wins running around in the top five here so far in 2013. Martin, a winner at Crossville this season. Hunter, a winner down in Georgia. White, I believe, a winner at Wartburg earlier this season. Hedgecock, a winner at 411 and at Smoky Mountain. And Matt Henderson, winner at 411 last Saturday night. As the leaders are about to close up on the back of the pack and encounter some heavy, heavy traffic. As we close in on lap number, on the 10 lap mark, as Dan Tipton's 12T slows going down the back straightaway. It looks like his night's gonna be finished. As the leaders start working traffic, Dean Bowen about to go a lap down. The race leader, Mark Martin, down into turn number one. Hunter closes up on Martin. He'll go down the back straightaway. The front four nose to tail down into turn three. Martin to the bottom. He'll go beneath the eight of Chris Chandler to put him a lap down. As we've got 10 scored, a fourth of the way home here in this one. 10 down, 30 remain. Martin the leader, Hunter second. White third, Hedgecock fourth, and Henderson is fifth. They stay in the top five. As Hedgecock now working on Ross White, trying to grab the third spot away. Yes, Mark Martin trying to drive off into the night here at Volunteer Speedway and pick up one of the biggest wins of his career. The storied veteran formerly out of Baxter, now residing in Cookeville, Tennessee. Mark Martin in the number 90, but Ethan Hunter, the youngster out of Tiger, Georgia's getting that momentum up on the top side and starting to run down the leader a bit now as they work off two down the back straightaway. White Lightning, Ross White holds down position three. Corey Hedgecock still fourth with Matt Henderson fifth. Josh Collins is sixth. Magma Carter seventh. Riverside rides in eighth. Jason Trammell is ninth. Ryan King, the final car in the top 10. Yes, we'll have 15 laps scored this time right here, 15 down. As Martin puts the 16 of Brad Lowe a lap down. Hunter with a good runoff, two down the back straightaway, closes up on Martin's back bumper, and Ross White right there with him as well. Down the front straightaway, 16 in the books, 24 to go. Martin now with just a little bit of breathing room as Hunter's got a back bumper full of White Lightning as they work down the back straightaway and into turn number three. Hunter right on the back bumper of Martin as the front two counter traffic down into turn number one. Kendall Gill up on the top side of Jason Cardwell. They ride in front of race leader Mark Martin down into turn three. Hunter second, White third. Here comes the 23 of Corey Hedgecock to the bottom of White. He's going to try to grab the third spot away from Ross White. He's got it done down into turn number one. But White right back around the outside of Hedgecock. He'll retake that third spot as the leader Mark Martin trying to be meticulous in traffic right here and find a way around Cardwell and Gill. Meanwhile, Ethan Hunter looking for a place to pounce. Hunter looking to the inside of Martin for the lead. They're side by side, all four down the front straightaway as the halfway signals down. 20 down, 20 to go here in this one. Yeah, we got a car to the inside. That's the 16 machine. Brad Lowe pulls that mount into the infield. His night is done. As Martin continues to work traffic, Hunter looking to the inside, not able to make the move. Martin's been dealing with the cars of Gill and Cardwell for several laps now. He's around Gill. He'll look to the inside of Cardwell to try to get some breathing room from Ethan Hunter. And he's got it done now with 22 down, 18 to go. Martin the leader, Hunter second, Hedgecock third, White fourth, Henderson is fifth as the leader's working heavy traffic. The 10 of Bland, Virginia's Kenny Compton calls it a night. He'll pull his machine into the infield pit area. Martin now with a bit of breathing room, about a half straightaway back to the second place running machine of Ethan Hunter. As we start to close in on the lap 25 mark, we got a car slowed up on the high side coming down the front straightaway. Don't know if that's going to draw a caution flag or not. It's the 63 of Josh Collins, and we do have caution. Caution is out. with problems on that machine, and he is ducked into the infield pit area off the exit of the pulled green flag, and we are going to be coming to green next time by. Twenty-four down, 16 to go. Single file, nose to tail. They'll restart here at the exit of turn four. Mark Martin in charge of the restart. Eyes on him. Green's out. Oh, we got a car out of shape. Steve Smith out of line up in turn number three, but the green flag waves, and we are back underway. Martin showing away. Hunter second, Hitchcock third, White fourth. Here comes the 51 of Mac McCarter trying to work beneath Matt Henderson for the fifth spot. Not able to get the job done as of yet. 14 laps remaining as Steve Smith, number three, slowing down into turn three and four. And looks like he'll be making the left turn. And nope, he's going to stop on the racetrack and draw the caution flag. Caution is out. And now Smith pulls the three machine into the infield. 26 laps are complete. 26 down, 14 remain. Lights are out. We're getting ready to come back to green. Mark Martin in charge of the restart. Eyes on him. Green's back out, and here we go. 14 laps to settle it. Here in the Big Hill Steelhead Late Model Championship. Martin's led it the entire way. Ethan Hunter has run second the entire distance. Corey Hitchcock is third. Ross White fourth. And Matt Henderson fifth. And Henderson taking a look to the inside of White. They may have touched there off of turn number four. White going to hang on to that fourth spot for the time being. McCarter fifth. Size six. Anthony White, he is in the eighth spot now. Trammell ninth. And Henry tenth. Anthony White started in the 14th spot and rides in the 8th position in that 2X car. As Martin continues to show the way, we'll be 11 laps shy of the finish right here, 29 laps up on the Fairway Ford scoreboard down in turn 1 and 2. Martin looking very good right now in that Warrior race car as there'll be 10 to go this time right here, 10 laps remain. Martin looks to be on cruise control at this point. Hunter in second. Hitchcock third. White fourth. Henderson fifth. McCarter sixth. Sice is seventh. White is eighth. Henry ninth. And Trammell rides in tenth. There'll be eight to go right here when race leader Mark Martin works off turn number four. Eight to go in Vic Hill Steelhead Late Model Championship here at Volunteer Speedway. Martin coming down the front straightaway one more time, and they are, if they stay green, they will catch slower traffic before this one is said and done. Martin out to about a third of a straightaway over the 15 of Ethan Hunter. And Hunter not able to do anything with him at this point. As the one of Barrett Lowe drops to the low side of the racing surface, they're going to give the leader, Mark Martin, plenty of racing room as there'll be five to go right here, five to go in the Steelhead Late Model Championship here at Volunteer Speedway, and it is all Mark Martin out in front. He is the man at this point. Ethan Hunter holds the second spot, Corey Hitchcock third, Ross White fourth, Matt Henderson fifth, those front five unchanged at this point. As we've got less than four laps remaining. There'll be three to go this time for Mark Martin, looking to get the biggest win of the season for him, without a doubt. Young man that has been dominant parts of the season at Crossville Speedway in Crossville, Tennessee. There will be two laps to go right here, two to go for Mark Martin, and a close encounter with Kevin Gill right there. Just at the flag stand, he puts Gill another lap down. As they work off turn number four, they'll be coming to the white flag. One lap to go for Mark Martin. Martin off of turn two, down the back straightaway for the final time and into turn three. The 2013 Vic Hill Steelhead Late Model Championship goes to the 90 of Mark Martin. Ethan Hunter will come home in second. Corey Hitchcock into 23 will finish third. Fourth goes to the zero of Ross White, and fifth to the 17 of Matt Henderson.
And getting the safety equipment off here, we get a few words from the winner of the Vic Hill Steelhead Late Model Championship. He had the number 90 machine. He's out, race fans. He can hear you. Give him a big round of applause out of Baxter. Baxter, Tennessee, the Baxter Bullet, Mark Martin. Young man waving to the crowd. And they're going to get the trophy set up here, and then we're going to jump in here and get a few words with our winner. And we'll go ahead and let these guys get some photos made here real quick. Check 1, 2, all right. And now get some more photos made here before we get a few words with our winner. And a longtime racing veteran from the Central Tennessee area, East Central Tennessee area, I guess you would say. Many feature wins at the old Tennessee Motor Speedway up in his hometown in Baxter, Tennessee, and several feature wins over the last two or three seasons at Crossville Speedway in Crossville, Tennessee. And I'm going to jump in here and get a few words with him. Mark Martin, congratulations. This hot rod was extremely fast tonight. You roll out. You got the Eagle Racing Engines overall top qualifier award. And, man, I don't know if you guys had to do anything to this thing at all tonight, but it was on a rail from the time y'all took it off a trailer, looked like.
You know, it was. And this is the first time I've come to the racetrack in a long time that I really didn't do nothing. I just told them, you know, what I needed, and they gave it to me. And, you know, it was great, man. The car was way faster than the driver, I'll tell you that.
I don't know about that, but you seem to like these high bank racetracks where you do your weekly racing at Crossville Speedway in Crossville, Tennessee. High banked a little bull ring, not necessarily a bull ring here at Volunteer Speedway, but still a high banked, extremely fast racing surface. And your car looked so comfortable up around the top. It looked like it was nice and free. Once you got going there, you may have been tight a little bit on the throttle early on, but once you got to making some green flag laps, it looked like that race car freed up real nice for you, and you were just able to roll that thing up there.
Yeah, I did. When I started the race, I had too much brakes on the front because we'd been just, you know, a little bit loose, and I told Vic it was a little bit loose, and he tightened it up with the right front spring and shock, and so I had to crank some brakes on the rear, and I probably didn't quite get enough there all night.
We'll let you thank your sponsors real quick, and then you guys can get down there into the Rusty Wallace Auto Group Victory Lane and get what's probably going to be a whale of a celebration going on.
Well, we can't celebrate too much. We're going to Crossville's got a big race tomorrow night, and we're going to try to follow this up with a Crossville victory if possible. And I want to thank Vic Hill Race Cars, Warrior Race Cars by Vic Hill, and all my guys that come out with me to help me on this thing.
Give him a big round of applause, Rays fans, once again. The Baxter Bullet out of Baxter, Tennessee. Mark Martin, the winner of the Vic Hill Steelhead, a late model championship. Doug, back upstairs to you, sir.